Today we're going to be painting a short ramp. This piece has been wire brushed and is clean. Where first thing we're going to do is wash it with alcohol to get the surface pretty much spotless. Because as long as I'm getting a change of color, it tells me I haven't got all the dirt off of it. Clean. This is one of the weak areas in both short and long rams where the heat risers tubes come up. You can get corrosion in this area. Now on the long rams, these are not bolts, so they are threaded studs. On short rams, they're bolts that are going into threaded portions of the casting. More often than not, you'll find that they've been corroded and perhaps somebody has gone for the next size bigger bolt in order to get enough thread engagement. But when you've got it off, this is the point to address any weakness in this area and to get it fixed. One of the tougher sections to paint and to clean are these valleys, these recesses in here. That it's just hard to get at them for cleaning. But it's also hard to paint because the paint won't want to spray into the area. It'll bounce back up. So you got to use some talent. I use light coats in here and do a bunch of them from different angles. Pretty much get this painted first. Alcohol bath completed. Now we'll going to wipe with a white cloth to be sure that we don't get any dark residue off, and that tells me it's clean. Clean, clean, clean. You might think it's the middle of the winter, but it's actually pretty close to April 1st. 12 degrees when I came down this morning. You can hear the heat running in the background. Okay. Speaking of heat, now we need to get this warm before we paint it, because the paint will stick much better to a warm surface. So this is how I warm it up. That's a standard heat gun used for stripping paint. And I just clamp it in place and let it play on the different sections of the manifold and keep moving it around. And then go off and do something else and move the manifold, do something else, move the manifold. And so while it's heating up, we'll take this opportunity to get our painter's tape out and mask off the sections of the manifold that we don't want to get painted. So there's the carb base mask off. I am a big fan of painter's tape. painters, I use masking tape. Never thought about painter's tape. Boy, that stuff is so easy to work with, so easy to remove. Painter's tape. And there you have the masking complete. I'm still playing the heat gun on it, getting the thing up to temperature.
The funnel for the heat here to paint the bottom side first. I've got my legs warm.
There you go. In my opinion, you can never have enough good light for painting. And I find by carrying that little high-intensity flashlight, it picks up areas that I would have missed, and then I can take care of thin sections. I'm using the Bill Hirsch paint. I'm a real fan. That's good coverage, nice quality, and it's the right color paint. While we're talking about painting and the right color paint to put on ramps, I've seen an awful lot of short ramps that are less natural color. Golly, I'm pretty sure that they should be painted the same engine turquoise. I see in the early pictures, I guess they're kind of hard to tell because they're black and white. But golly, I really think the consensus is short ramps should be painted turquoise.
When you set the painted side up to stand up, so you look it over, you go inside.
And there you have it. Sit to dry.